hey, what's going on? Welcome to our channel. So me and Nat did get back from Tulum a little while ago, but we couldn't get this video out just because we had so many other different things planned and we were just so busy. So we do apologize for that. But if you do want to check out the blog she did, I'll put it in the description below. It's really detailed. It's really well put together. It has pretty much everything that we did in Tulum. We're going to be showing you guys a little bit of things that we got to film, but like all the other little extra details that we couldn't film and stuff like that is in the blog, including everything else that we did. So it's just a good little piece of written work if you want to check out. So yeah, we ended up staying at the Amansala Hotel in Tulum just because the Zuluk Hotel that we had originally booked kind of clicked us like the last 2 days. They didn't even inform us. We had to find out that the hotel was shut down for like the whole September from like a photographer there, which kind of threw us off guard. So we had to book like a different place, which ended up being Amansala. The hotel was $650 and it included free breakfast and they gave us 2 free bites. The breakfast was really good because it was a limited menu. We got to try something new every single day and we tried everything that was on the menu. And I can confirm that everything that was on the menu tasted good, which is always a good thing because it's always, how often have you stayed at a place that it's so many misses? It's very rare that you stay in a place where everything is a hit, but everything there was a hit. Again, like I said, we got to try everything. It was good. So it just gave us something to look forward to every morning. Beyond that, we got to take their bikes and we rode around town, which was pretty cool because you get to stop in different places and check different places out. So if you're in Tulum, getting on a bike, a scooter, something like that is always a good idea because there's so much to experience, so much to see around, and it's always a good thing to actually take that, I call it a little slow path, because cars, you can't really experience much in a car because it's just going too fast. On a bike, on a scooter, you get to be able to stop, check it out, get back on, stop, check it out, get back on. And that's exactly what we did in the town. So it just gave us a good view of the entire thing as a whole. So while we were riding our bikes, we had the destination to go to Pablo Escobar's mansion. And we used the bikes that was provided to us by the hotel. And I was falling all over the place because the bike that I had, the chain was messed up. It was real old and real rusty. And I just kept falling. So maybe, you know, Amansala should take a look at that. Before we got to the hotel, we ran into some people that told us that the Pablo Escobar's mansion now charges $100 to get in. And that's because it's trying to compensate and make some type of revenue for all the people that just come in just to take pictures and then leave out. So the place is actually a hotel and, you know, its purpose is for people to come in, stay in, eat, sleep. You know, they have to make money. If all people do is come in, take pictures for Instagram and leave, then they're not really making anything. So they charge you $100 and then $50 of the charge goes towards you. It goes towards your drink if you want to eat or anything like that. So it's kind of like a win for them and also a win for you because you do get to get in and do take your pictures and you're free to explore and you can spend the $50 towards drinks. And it's a really cool place. It's huge. It's if you're gonna go to Tulum, I do recommend you going to see it. His beach area is amazing. You know, like he was really living a good life. Lost in an endless maze, the emptiness had afforded just like a void, but you broke the coldness somehow and lit up a flame. Ooh, I was done feeling hopeless, screamed out loud because it felt impossible in my bones, like getting blood out of the stone on my own. But you came around every moment.
of my favorite places from, you know, the entire trip was the food we had at Rosa Negra. Of course, it was like a lot of, it was a lot more expensive. I want to say like the meal was between like $150 to like $200. And, but it was for Nat's birthday, so.
Oh my God.
That's all. The third one, the less spicy. Green tomato with jalapeno pepper. It's a little spicy. Second one. Peanut with gray pepper. It's made with spices.
Okay.
The last one. Be careful. It's habanero pepper with honey. This is the most spicy.
Most spicy.
With this, you can speak Spanish. Perfect spicy, 10 seconds.
Yeah? Yeah. Thank you.
The next day, we took a trip to Tulum Town. It cost us 250 pesos from our hotel. Now, Tulum Town was absolutely beautiful, lots of food options to choose from, and everything was relatively inexpensive compared to the beach area. I actually wished I had spent some more time in Tulum Town, but if I ever return, that's the first place that I'm going to explore.
We are in Tulum Town right now. We just left Puerto Rico. Tacos, a little quesadilla that looked like a taco. It's pretty funny. But anyway, if you're ever in Tulum, it's a good place to check out. It's pretty cheap, pretty affordable, but it's really good.
So we stopped at this little restaurant. It's called Yashi, which is also known as the Green Chili.
And we decided to just order something random, something that we don't usually order because we like to order the same stuff. So we're here, we're experimenting, we're trying new things, and here you have it. It's a shrimp. I think it's like a, you said like curry with like some rice around the bottom, and then we have this little spread right here. The two sauces are hot. Then you have the salsa right there. This is it's a little different.
It's a roasted pepper.
Yeah. Considering like guacamole, it's a little fast.
It's a famously known thing in Tulum.
Then we have the passion fruit margaritas. Nat already tasted hers because she can never wait. She always has a rush and jump into stuff. So yeah, we should try to dive into this. We got free bread on the house too, so that's free stuff on the house. So if you're in Tulum, if you're in the area, make sure you come check this spot out. Like I said, she had it already. It was pretty good and it was happy hour. So I wanted to get another one.
I feel like you can't go to Mexico without trying out a cenote. I don't know how, like, what the numbers are, but it's like cenotes everywhere. We only went to two. We actually did a different cenote when we was like in our Riviera Maya, but in Tulum we only went to two. One was a hit and one was like a super bust because it was like a cenote, but it was like really nothing there. Like, we paid to get in. It had a little path. We walked, you know, straight to it, and it was just nothing. And like the water was like really dark. It was like scary type of, so we just was like, nah, this is not it. This is not it at all. But beyond that, we went to Gran Cenote, and it was amazing. It was, like, such a wonderful experience. It is pricey compared to, like, a lot of the other cenotes, but is it worth it? Absolutely. I remember I was swimming, and, like, the water was blue. Like, I don't know. It was just a cool experience. I've never done something like that, so I really liked it. Check out Gran Cenote if you're ever there.
Hey everyone, so it is Marius and I's last morning in Tulum. It's our final morning here, and this honestly has been such a magical trip. We went to a cenote yesterday, if you guys have already saw. Right now we are enjoying this gorgeous sunrise at the pool, at the beach. The waves are crashing. Marius is doing laps this morning, but we're so blessed to be here. Today our schedule is kind of open. We have to check out our hotel at 12, at 12 o'clock, and then we have a shuttle to take us to our next property at 1 p.m. So I'm super excited.
Oh.
cute. Oh my god. I don't want to mess up your ribbon.
Don't worry about it.
No. I'm just gonna like this. What is this? What? A Telfar bag? She has a Telfar? YSL bag. Shoes?
Could be. Thank you, Marius.